Hello, my name is Christian Geiler. I'm working for the Europe North organization. And today, it's a happy day. I want to talk about my favorite topic, the machine control, also known as the MCO mode in Shekel. In order to break down and show you the specifics, I will first show you how it's done today. That means we'll go over some functions, the design, the layout and everything. And then I will switch over to the new MCO mode, and then we'll take it from there and I will show you all the new stuff. And I assure you it will be exciting. I start by opening up Shekel. I have prepared a small stick facade, FWS50, with some floor and head recess. And just click on that one. Shekel already knows a lot of the working operations, like the T-cleats and floor recess in this case and so on, and drainage. So all the known information is already given. And this you can see under the technical and processing settings here in the left menu. If you click here, you can see, for example, the T-cleats that I've chosen, the one for a CNC machine, the oval one. And depending on my settings here, the processing will also appear in my element. But of course, we not only want to use the standard processing, maybe we want to add or change or remove something. And then we have the possibility to go into the Shekel processing mode. So what I do now, I have a lot of possibilities to go there. I could use the top menu and choose processing on top. I could also right click on the profile where I want to do some changes and say processing mode, or I can also left click on the profile like this and here go directly to the processing mode. And now the Shekel MCO mode opens up, and first you can see here to the left we have the windows, the processing window. And all the profiles are hidden through this field information. That means if I search for a specific profile, I need to know to what, which field it belongs. And this is maybe not so easy, but if I expand this and I search, for example, Mullion 1, I see, for example, my T-cleat here with a specific functionality. And here you have the coordinates, the X, the U, the Z values. And if I change something here, which you shouldn't of course do, but I do it here, I change the position, Y position from 16 to 20 millimeters. You see nothing happens because you have to click apply on the bottom here. Then it executes. And then you will also get a small asterisk next to the article number. This means it shows you that something has been done. So, what I want to do now is also show you the windows here, because what you have here in the main window, this shows exactly all the processing which will be sent to a CNC machine. And also you have the thumbnail image here up in the right corner. Here you can select all the profiles you want to process or change, and you can easily zoom in, zoom out, and select the profiles you need. And if you double click the mouse, you will get the maximum size of the element within the window. And if you want to access the profile on the back side, you can easily do this by putting down shift and press the scrolling wheel on the mouse, and you can then rotate the element so you can access every profile. This is very useful. So, and then we have the section view window. And here is where you can see all the cross section, you can see the profile, and also you have the sides of the profile, the pages, the 1, 2, 3, and 4. And if you click on page 1, like you have here, you will see the profile from top, and here you see it from the right, from the bottom, and from the left. So here you can see everything. It's also possible to resize this window like this, just move up and down. The same thing with the thumbnail view. for instance, recommendation, if you have two or more monitors, I always make this larger and I move this to a second screen. This makes it much easier and you get a better workspace to work, especially when you work with bigger facades, for example. What I would like to do now is show you how it looks in the new MCO mode. To do this, I need to access or type in a new release code. And this you have to do with the Shokal Infobox, the small app you have on your desktop, hopefully. If you can't find this Infobox, you can always reactivate it. Therefore, I leave the MCO mode and I go to General, Help, and Shokal InfoPoint. If you click here, you will definitely directly get it on your screen back again. And also when you activate this MCO new, Shokal must be closed. So I go to General, say Exit, and I close down Shokal. So, what's important now, if I go to Toolbox, I go to Additional Components, where I always put in my release codes, say the installation language is English, is okay. So, you have to think of the following. Not only that Shokal must be closed, you also have to do this installation on every local computer in the company. Doesn't matter if you're running Shokal on a network, you have to do this for every computer. And you also have to have the latest Shokal version installed on a computer. This means the release 2019, release 3, and then you can activate this function. With the new coming Shokal version 2020, this will be activated automatically. So I enter the code 24451. Say next. I say this is exactly what I want. I don't want to add any additional release codes, and say exit. So now I've activated this new function for Shokal. So I can start up Shokal again. So, Shokal starts up. I use the same position as before, my little stick facade. Open it up. And here, of course, nothing differs because we're not yet in the processing mode. I go there by clicking on Mullion 1. Now I go to processing mode. And da-da! Here it is, the new MCO mode. For starters, if we look at the processing window to the left, we have all here. You know, in the past, we had everything sorted by field. In the new version, we have everything sorted by profile type and glass or panel. That means all the glasses, the panels, the mullions, the transoms, all the profiles included in the element are shown here in a much more structured way. That makes it a lot easier to find. Still, like in the old version, you can search for an article number up here. If you, for example, search for the mullion profile, we enter 322, 280, you will see everything will be marked. Wherever it finds this article number, it will be a selection. This is actually nothing new. But if we remove this article number, you also see here, you have like a filter function. That means you can filter between text, the set position, and also what I find really useful, user-defined processing. For example, if I search for text here, I click to the right on text, and then I find all the words, the names used in this element. For example, I can search for all the mullions and all the transoms. And then you will see here in the background, that all the mullions and transoms are shown only. I'll take this away. I can also search for a set position, or I could also search for the user-defined process. But so far we don't have any user-defined process, so there's nothing to filter. So I will zoom in my profile. I will select the profile here. I could right-click here and say New Process, or I could easily also select my profile here in my processing window. I do this for now, right-click on a mullion and say New Process. And here you can add 10 different type of processing everything from holes, countersinks, slots, notching, everything. So I will start by adding a new hole to the profile. I hold down my scrolling wheel and zoom in the profile, and now you see here the hole is hanging on to my mouse and it jumps between the end and the start point of the profile, the reference point. And the only thing I know for now is that the height of this hole should be 50 millimeters. This means I could lock this. So I type 50 millimeters, and then to lock this I hit the tab button on my keyboard. And now you see it's locked. Now I can only move the hole in the Y direction. So I say, okay, I'm not exactly sure of the Y position, so I just put it here. I have to check the profile height first to get it in the middle. So I place it over here. And now you see the properties are open up to the left for this hole. That means first we have a name for it. It's automatically named to hole 10 millimeter in diameter. And the type is hole because I choose hole, but I can always change it to another processing if I want. Then we have the 0 point. And this is actually new. Didn't have before. In the past, we could only work with one reference point. Here we can change the reference point. Either work from the start of the profile or from the end of the profile, or we could select one of the joints. In our case, we have, like you see here, 4 different joints. Because we have like 1, 2, 3, 4 where we can use as a reference points where the transoms are. And we can also say where we want to put this. Then we have the page view, the section view, and this is accordingly to this view here what we want to do. And in this case, maybe if I want to move the page from page 2 to page 4, you also see that the hole will jump to the page 4. Like you see there. And then we have the corner section view. You see the little cross here, 0 point. We can also put it on top, and then we'll come up here. But I think we'll leave it at the bottom. The only thing I want to do now, the depth. Like you see here, you have 10 millimeter, which is actually good. But if I want to push this hole through the profile, I could easily just type 50 millimeters here. That would also do the job. But if I maybe later on change the profile system to FWS 16, it wouldn't work anymore. So maybe we could do this another way. Here to the right, you'll see a small checkbox. If I left click on this one, formula field opens up. I can click on the 3-dot button here. And you see here, you get into the formula editor. This means if we, for example, now use the profile width as a formula by double-clicking, say OK, then you see the hole goes through the profile. And now if I change the profile system, it will also be 60 millimeters instead of 50 millimeters. And this is always the way you try to do things. When you add processing or working operations, try to do them as flexible as possible. Then you can use them for as many projects as possible, so you don't have like 100 of different types. Now I've shown you some of the functionality, the design in the old mode and as well as in the new mode, and I think you also saw the big differences also with the filter functions, the search functions. And if you put this side by side, you will definitely be able to see the differences. In the upcoming videos, we will show you more functionality of the MCO New and how you can benefit checking parts of this.